गुड मॉर्निंग, हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम पूर्णिमा एंड वंस अगेन आई एम बैक विथ यू विद द सेम लेसन चिल्ड्रन डिटर्मिनर। एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी वेलकम यू टू माय दिस सेशन, ओके। एंड ऑफ द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज डिटर्मिनर। सो एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट देर आर 8 टाइप्स ऑफ डिटर्मिनर्स आर देयर, आर्टिकल्स, डिमॉन्स्ट्रेटिव डिटर्मिनर, पॉसेसिव डिटर्मिनर, कार्डिनल्स, ऑर्डिनल्स, quantifiers, distributive and integrative determiners. So these are the 8 types of determiners I've told you. And children, we have also discussed in our previous video about articles and demonstrative determiners. So student, today I am going to discuss with you possessive determiner. That is the third type of determiner I'm going to discuss with you. Children, that is possessive determiner. So before explaining children possessive determiner, let me tell you what is the meaning of possessive. Possessive children are used to show possession. Possessive means to use to show possession. Now what do you mean by possession? Possession means whatever you have. Possession means whatever you have, that is a possession. So I'm going to teach you possessive determiners. That means whatever determiners are there which shows that you are owing that thing, or which shows that you are having that thing. So that is, children, is a possessive determiner. And determiners, as I told you, it is always used before noun. Okay. So now just guess what type of positive determiners you are going to study today. So student, I was telling you about possessive determiner. Okay. Now children, what is determiner? First of all, children, determiners are used before noun. Now children, what is possessive determiner? So children, my, his, her, okay, these are, and there are many positive determiners like it's, their, our, okay, my, his, her, it's, their, our. So these are some of the positive determiners I have written on the board. Children, your can also be a positive determiner. Okay, like for example, let's start with your. Your pen is with me. Now children, pen is a noun and your is a possessive determiner which is coming before noun. Your pen is with me. My city is very clean. My city is very clean. Okay, city is a noun and my is a possessive determiner. His copies are updated. His copies are noun, children, and children, it is his copies are updated. Her. Okay, so children, what is the meaning of her? Her is her frock is very nice. Her frock is very nice. Okay. So children, frock is a noun here and her is one. Let me make you one thing clear to you children. Still you people are in ninth and you are not knowing that where to use her and where to use his. Okay. So children, her is used with female and his is used with male person. All right. Similarly, children, there is one possessive determiner there. Okay. So many people are confused with their and there. So this is positive determiner. Children, there is related with the people and there is related, there, there is related with place. And you often get confused when you write the answer. You people are often confused between there there and between there there. So then children, I will be telling you what is his name. What is his name? Name is a noun. What is her name? Okay. Their house is very big. Their, T-H-E-I-R. Their house is very big. Their house. Children, their. I'm talking about T-H-E-I-R. Their means their, the people. House. House is a noun. So, their is a possessive determiner. Children, their here show the possession. Possession of a house. Our neighbor is a rich man. Now children, neighbor is a noun and our neighbor is a rich man. Then children, do you know its value? Do you know its value? Value is again is a children noun and it is a possessive determiner. Okay, so possessive determiners are used to show possession. Now children, this should be clear to you. So what is possessive determiner? Possessive determiners are those determiners which are used to show possession. Okay, so don't forget now what is a possessive determiner. Now children, I'm going to take the next determiner, that is the fourth determiner and the fifth determiner, that is cardinals or cardinals and ordinals, or we can rather say ordinals and cardinals. Okay, so what is ordinal children? Children, first, second, okay, third, we can also write next, last. These are some of the ordinals. First, second, third, next, last. Okay, so children, the ordinal shows that what position something has in a series. So what does ordinal shows? It shows that what position something has in series. What position something has in series. He is second. He is having second position in his class. So children, in a series, the student is having second position. In a series, the student is having second position. Okay. I shall meet him the next week. So children, next week, the series of week is there and I shall meet him the next week. He is the last man to help me. He is the last man to help me. So there are children, series of many person and he is the last man to help him. Man is a noun and children here, last is the cardinal. Ordinals. Okay, so children, what are ordinal? Ordinal tell what position something has in a series. So don't forget it, what position something has in series. Now children, we will come to cardinals. 1, 2, 3. Okay, these are some of the cardinals. Children, what is cardinal? Let's see. They show how many of something there are. So, what is a cardinal student? Cardinal are those determiners which shows that how many of something there are. How many of something there are. So, this is cardinal. Like, there were only 10 boys in the class. There were only 10 boys in the class before the examination started. Okay. He has two daughters. He has two daughters. So they are showing how many of something a person has. He balanced himself on one foot. He balanced himself on one foot. Okay. She lived for 80 years. I met three young men at the station. So children, these are showing how many of something there are. So this is children, which determiner? This is cardinal. This is cardinal. Okay. So, children, we have learned how many types of determiner we have learned. We have learned, children, first of all, let me revise once again. What is a determiner? Determiners are those words which comes before noun. Okay. Then, children, I have told you about 8 types of determiner, articles. Okay. Then, children, demonstrative determiner, then possessive, cardinals, ordinals. Okay, and children, after that we will do read very important determiner, that is quantifier, and then distributive and integrative determiner. Okay, now children, so till I have done till five determiner we have done. We have finished article. I have told you in article there are two type of article, where they are definite and indefinite. We have done that. Then children, I have told about distributive determiner, this, that, these, those. We have finished that also. Possessive, just now I have told you, my, your, own, its, their. Okay, these are some of the possessive determiner. And of course I have described children ordinals and cardinals with you. What is the difference between ordinals and cardinals? Ordinal children, cardinal shows how many of something are there, and ordinal so show children what position something has in a series. So this is the major difference between ordinal and cardinal. And now children, I will be telling you something about quantifiers. So children, I was talking to you about quantifiers. Okay, now children, quantifier is the sixth determiner. Okay, and I've already told you about five determiners, about the uses in detail. Now children, I will be telling you about the sixth determiner, that is quantifiers. You can see quantifier is written. So what is a quantifier? First of all, what is a quantifier determiner? So quantifier determiner is that determiner which is used before noun, and it tells children amount of something. First of all, what does it tell? Amount of something, or children, the quantity of things. Children, either they refer to the amount of something or they refer to the quantity of things. So this is amount of something and quantity of things. So what is this, children? This is a quantifier. Now children, there are many quantifiers are there, and those quantifiers, I think some of the quantifiers are so important that I will be telling you the use of these quantifiers separately. Okay, and there are many quantifiers like much, some, several, lot of, both of, so many quantifiers are there. So what is quantifier, children? Quantifier tells the amount of something or quantity of things. Amount of something or quantity of things. There are many quantifiers like some, any, much, many, little, a little, the little. And I will be telling you now the use, because children, quantifier is a very vast topic. It is not a very small topic like ordinals and cardinals. Okay, so I will be telling some of the uses of quantifiers. And my first children, quantifiers will be some and any. So I will be telling you about some and any, the use of some and any. So first of all, this is a children, this determiner is a, will come in the category of quantifiers. And now children, I will be telling you about the use of some and any. All right, now as we all know that children, sum is that determiner which is generally used with children with a positive sentence or with as affirmative sentence. So children, where do we use sum? Sum is that determiner which is generally used with positive sentence or affirmative sentence, while as children, any is used in interrogative sentence or and negative sentence. So children, please remember this thing, that some is, it is used with positive sentence, and any is used with negative and interrogative. Okay, interrogative, some is used with positive, and any is used with negative and interrogative sentence. Okay, now children, it tells about the quantity of things. It tells about the quantity of things. So children, Some is generally used in the affirmative sentence. I want to have some sugar in my coffee. That is a positive sentence. I don't want any sugar in my coffee. Negative. So you can see, children, the use of some and any. I want some sugar in my coffee. That is positive. I don't want any sugar in my coffee. That is negative. Okay. So children, first of all, some is used in the positive sentence or affirmative sentence, and any is used in negative sentences. Children, similarly, no is also used in negative and interrogative sentences. Just like any, children, no is also a determiner and it is used in negative and interrogative sentence. Like, there is no post office in this colony. This is a negative sentence. There is no post office in this colony. There is no post office in this colony. So this is a negative sentence. Okay. Now, we have invited some TV anchors in the show. We have invited some TV anchors to the show. So children, or you can say that, children, there is still some milk in the jug. There is still some milk in the jug. Then children, let's, so you can see, children, some is used with positive sentence. No is used with negative sentence. Now let's give you some example of any, which is used in interrogative sentence and which is used in negative sentence. Okay. There isn't any sugar in the pot. There is not any sugar in the pot. This is a negative sentence. And then, have you any books on Western music? Have you any books on yoga? So children, this is an interrogative sentence. Okay. Children, it's not that some is always used in the positive sentence. Sometimes some is used in the interrogative sentence, children. But children, it should be request or invitation. Just remember, children, that some is also used in the interrogative sentence when it is related with request or invitation. Okay. So don't get confused that some is always used in affirmative sentence. But maximum it is used in the affirmative sentence. But children, sometimes, children, some is also used in interrogative sentence, and that sentence should be related with request and, children, what is that? Invitation. Like, will you have some tea? It is an invitation. Won't you spare some time for me? Again, children, request. Didn't I lend you some money yesterday? Okay. So, and will you spend some days with us? Again, this is a request. So, children, Annie is using interrogative sentence to make an inquiry. And children, generally, Annie is using that interrogative sentence which makes inquiry. Is there any news? So what is this type of an interrogative sentence? It is related to the inquiry. Won't you then, has the postman brought any letters for me? Again, this is an interrogative sentence, but it is somebody is inquiring about something. Didn't you buy anything from the general store? Again, this is an inquiry. Okay, so children, some is generally used with a affirmative sentence, but some is also used with interrogative sentence, but it should be related with request or invitation. Similarly, children, any is always used with negative sentence and interrogative sentence, but children, that interrogative sentence should be related with the inquiry. So this is the major use of some and any. Okay. Now children, sometimes, children, any is also used with hardly, barely, scarcely. Like, there is hardly any sugar in the house. Okay. So any is always used with, not some, any is always used with hardly, barely, and scarcely. There is hardly any sugar, any money with him. He has hardly any money on him. There's hardly any sugar in the house. She has barely any beautiful dress. He has scarcely any friend in this new city. Scarcely means very less. He has scarcely any friend in this new city. So children, you can see I've told you the use of some and any. Okay. Now children, there is one more use of some, and that is, children, what is that? Some is used with a countable plural noun. What is that use, children? Some is used with countable plural noun. And children, da indicates an unknown or indefinite number, like some person always speak ill of other. Some person always speak ill of other. I bought a notebook and some paper. So children, some is used with countable noun, which means indefinite quantity. Okay. Now, children, one more this quantifier I will be discussing with you. That is all and both. Children, that is all and both. Okay. So I will be telling you about where we have to use all and where we have to use both. So all denote that total of many units. There are many units are there, and children, all denote that whole total unit. Okay. While both shows the total of two units. Okay. So please learn. You can note down this then, children. All denotes the total of many units together. While both shows a total of two units, like she gave me all the apples. Both Ajay and Vijay are fine cricketers. Both Dhoni and Virat are fine cricketers. So they are showing two units, but all the cricketers of India are playing very well. So it is showing all the cricketers. It is denoting the total of many units. Okay, now children, there is one note here that the is always used after all and both. Okay, like all the girls are present in the class, both the friend refused to part. Okay, and children, the is also used with whole. The whole village, okay, was ruined in the fire. So here children, the is used after all, the is used children after both, and children, the whole village. Okay, all, second children, all is used with countable and uncountable noun. All is always used with countable and uncountable noun, like all my books have been torn. It is used with countable noun. All the milk turned sour. Okay, so children, all is used with countable noun also and uncountable noun. Like children, milk is an uncountable noun and we are using all, and after is used after all. All the milk turned sour. All is used with both countable and uncountable noun. Children, you can note that all my books have been torn. So here children, it is a countable noun, and you can see the all is used with uncountable nouns, like all the milk turned sour. So children, this was the use of all and both. Okay, and I have also told about whole, and children, the is used after all and both. The is every time it is used with all and both. So you can see children, and the will also coming before whole. The whole unit was present there. Okay. Now children, the next quantifiers determiner which I will be taking is many and much. And children, I have written on the board, children, with many. Children, it is related with number, आर चिल्ड्रन क्वांटिटी इज रिलेटेड विथ मच. सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर चिल्ड्रन, मैनी इज ऑलवेज यूज विथ नंबर एंड मच इज रिलेटेड विद द क्वांटिटी. नाउ आई विल बी टेलिंग यू द यूज ऑफ मैनी. फर्स्ट आई विल बी टेलिंग यू द यूज ऑफ मैनी. ओके, मैनी शोज नंबर एंड इज यूज. मैनी शोज नंबर एंड इज यूज इन इंट्रोगेटिव एंड निगेटिव सेंटेंस. मैनी शोज नंबर and it is used in interrogative and negative sentence. Do you see many person? Do you see many person at the dinner? Okay, so this is interrogative. And she has not solved many sums. This is, she has not solved many sums. This is negative and it is used, many is used here with negative sentence, like she has not solved many sums. Negative is also used with children interrogative sentence. Okay, many, like did you see many person at the dinner? Now children, second use of many is as the subject or part of the subject. Many is used as the subject or part of the subject. Like many have been respected and admired. Many have been respected and admired. Respected is a verb here. And children noun and here children many is used here as a noun. Okay, many is used here as a noun. So many is a subject of this verb respect. Okay, so children, many sometimes used as a subject or a part of the subject. Many of us went to see the famous actor. Many of us, now children, here again many is a used here as a noun. Okay, of the subject, of the verb went, many is a subject here. So now children, there are many expression where we use many, like a good many. First expression is there many expression where many is used, like a good many, a great many, so many, too many, how many, as many. Okay, so I've known her for a great many years. I've known her for a great many years. Even if one person is her, that is one too many. Now children, many a good man has been destroyed by drink. Okay, so children, these were some of the important use of many. Many is always used as a numbers. And children, sometimes use, it is used with the interrogative and negative. And children, many is used as a subject in a sentence. Then children, it is used with many expressions like a good many, a great many, so many, too many, how many. There are so many expressions are there in which we use many. Okay. Now, children, then children, I will be telling the use of much. I will be telling the use of much. Much children, as you can see, it is used with quantity. Much is used with quantity. Okay. And a few notes I will be dictating you that what is the use of much. So first of all, much is shows quantity. As children, it is used in the same way as many was used in a sentence. So first of all, children, it is used with interrogatives. Does your cow give much milk? It is used with interrogative. And children, it is also used with negative. No, she doesn't give a great deal of milk. Okay. And children, it is replaced by a lot of. Or you can say, yes, she gives a lot of milk. Instead of saying, my cow gave much milk, you can say, yes, it is giving a lot of milk. So children, much is used with quantity and many is used with number. Please always remember this. Now many is followed by plural number. Many is followed by plural number while many a takes singular number after it. Okay, many is followed by plural number and many a takes singular number after it. Like many a flower is born to blush unseen. children, when many A will be there, so it is used with singular number. But if only many will be there, so it will be used with plural number. There is a small difference between A. A's, but A, but that A, when we include with many, it will make a lot of difference. Many A is used with singular number. Many is used with plural. Like many problems, plural. Many problems have come up suddenly. And children, many a flower is born to blush unseen. So children, here I have told you about the use of much, many, some, both, all. So these are some of the important quantifier. In my next video, some more quantifiers, children, I will be discussing with you. And with this, I conclude my video. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.